Do bed bugs sleep? Because if they do, I say it's high time we bite them back. Hey there, sleeping pill bugs. Julian here for DNews. We're still not exactly sure why we need to sleep, but almost every animal does it. Humans, cats, dogs, cats, birds, cats, even fish and cats. So just how deep does the rabbit hole go? Do insects, for instance, need a little shut compound eye? It's not an easy question to answer because it's not like bugs have eyelids they can actually close, and we still haven't devised tiny brainwave scanners that can detect a resting pattern. So scientists had to define what insect sleep looks like, and in 2000 they did just that. Two separate groups from the Neuroscience Institute of California and the University of Pennsylvania studied fruit flies to see if they behaved similarly to us. The researchers found that at night they were immobile and had a higher arousal threshold, meaning it took more than usual to startle them and get them moving. The scientists also found that if they deprived the flies of sleep at night by continually tapping the container they were in, the flies would rest during the day, exhibiting sleep rebound. If you've ever worked all night and then slept like a log in a coma the whole day, you can relate to the flies. And if you use caffeine to pull off an all-nighter, the flies can relate to you. Turns out the chemical that keeps us buzzing does the same for fruit flies. Since the first observations of fruit fly sleep in 2000, more insects have been caught napping. The males of some species of bee that don't live in hives sleep by locking their jaws onto a flower and relaxing the rest of their body. And if bees are kept awake, they show the same negative side effects we do. Biologist Barrett Klein studied the sleep of bees and invented a device called the insominator, which is officially the best name for anything ever. Game over, guys, go home. Klein would tag some bees with steel and some with copper. The insominator would keep the steel-clad bees awake by jarring them with magnets. Meanwhile, bees tagged with non-magnetic copper would be unaffected. The next day, when the steel-clad sleepy bees had to communicate where flowers were by doing the waggle dance, yes, that's the official name, they weren't as accurate as their well-rested brethren. Sleep deprivation makes bees a little muddled, just like us. And if it goes on for too long, it can have worse consequences. A study that kept fruit flies awake for an extended period saw a third of them die. So extreme sleep deprivation can be fatal for insects, just like us. Some researchers think if it doesn't outright kill them, it can shorten a bug's lifespan. A University of South Florida study of fire ants found that queens get much more rest than the workers. The queens would regularly doze off 90 times a day for 6 minutes at a time, which adds up to 9 hours. Workers, on the other hand, took minute-long power naps at random, 250 times a day. That adds up to less than 5 hours. Incidentally, workers only live up to a year, while queens can live for up to 6 years. The worker ant's sleeping pattern means that 80% of the colony is awake at any given time, so they can continuously get stuff done. Other insects sleep when there's not much point in being awake. Flowers close up at night, so honeybees can catch some Z's. Humans aren't on mattresses during the day, so bedbugs sleep then. The New Zealand weta lives at an altitude where it freezes overnight, so might as well get some cryo sleep while it's at it. And spiders? Spiders aren't insects. They never sleep. They're always watching. Kidding, probably. If you're a tired bee, maybe your mattress is your own insominator. Eve Mattresses has spent 4 years perfecting the memory foam mattress, and they sell it direct to you online at a third the price of traditional stores. And since you watch DNews, you can save even more. Go to www.evemattress.com now for your exclusive offer. Enter promo code DNews125 to get $125 off today. Hey, remember how I mentioned fish sleep and you were like, what? And you're really curious as to how that's even possible? Well, Trace and Dr. Kiki Sanford tell you all about it here.
Studies done recently in behavioral brain research, PLOS Biology, and Nature determined zebrafish have slower breathing cycles in sleep, take naps, can suffer from sleep deprivation, and are governed by melatonin, just like us.
Before we brought it up, I bet you never wondered if insects sleep, but these are the questions that keep us up at night. If you have your own you'd like us to answer, you can go ahead and ask us. That's what the comments are for. Subscribe to see if we answer your question in another video, and I'll see you next time on DNews.